Good morning, student. In this video, we will explain earth magnetism or terrestrial magnetism and its different parameters. Sir William Gilbert was the first scientist to investigate the phenomena of magnetism. According to scientist Gilbert, the origin of magnetism is due to circulating electric current. First point related to origin of magnetism is the rotation of Earth about its own axis is responsible for generation of electric current. There is electrification due to hot air near the equator and moving towards north hemisphere and south hemisphere. Second point related to the earth magnetism is the atmospheric gases gets ionized due to the interaction of the atmospheric gases with the radioactive materials and cosmic rays and high energy particles coming from the sun. So, strong electric field is produced as Earth rotates about its own axis around the sun. This current produces magnetic field, and this is the origin of earth magnetism. Let us see what is earth magnetism. A study of earth magnetic field is called terrestrial magnetism or geomagnetism. It is common experience that a bar magnet or a magnetic needle suspended freely in air always aligns itself along geographic north-south direction. If it has a freedom to rotate about horizontal axis, it inclines with some angle with the horizontal in the vertical north-south plane. Here is the diagram of earth magnetism. Okay, this is the geographic north pole, this is the geographic north pole, here is geographic south pole, this is the geographic axis R dash, this is magnetic axis M dash, this is B dash. Okay, different parameters of earth magnetisms are, first, magnetic axis. The earth is considered to be a huge magnetic dipole. Fictitious magnetic north pole of the earth is located below Antarctica, while the south pole S is below Norway. The straight line NS joining these two poles is called magnetic axis MM dash. Therefore, in this diagram, this is the MM dash. This MM dash is called as a magnetic axis. It is passing through the two poles, south pole and north pole. Next parameter is magnetic equator. A great circle in the plane perpendicular to magnetic axis is magnetic equatorial circle AA dash. It happens to pass through India near Thiruvananthapuram. See this diagram again. In this diagram, see this. This is the great circle A dash, and this is called as a magnetic equator. This is the second parameter of earth magnetism. Next, geographic meridian. Geographic meridian is defined as a plane perpendicular to the surface of the earth. Of course, this is the vertical plane, and this vertical plane is perpendicular to the geographic axis, is called as a geographic meridian. Therefore, in this figure, there are the two plane, both they are perpendicular to each other. This is called as a geographic meridian. This is perpendicular to the surface of earth and perpendicular to the geographic axis. Okay, next parameter is magnetic meridian. Magnetic meridian is defined as a plane perpendicular to the surface of earth and passing through the magnetic axis is magnetic meridian. Direction of resultant magnetic field of the earth is always along or parallel to the magnetic meridian. See this figure again. This is the magnetic meridian. This plane is called as a magnetic meridian. It is perpendicular to the surface of earth and perpendicular to the magnetic axis. Next is magnetic declination. It is denoted by letter alpha. Angle between the geographic and the magnetic meridian at a place is called magnetic declination alpha. The declination is small in India. It is 0 degree and 58 minute west at Mumbai and 0 degree 41 minute east at Delhi. Thus, at both these places, magnetic needle shows true north accurately. Angle alpha is called as a magnetic declination. See this figure again. Angle between the geographic meridian and angle between the magnetic meridian is called as a angle of declination. Next is magnetic inclination or angle of dip. It is denoted by letter phi. Magnetic inclination or angle of dip is defined as it is the angle between the direction of resultant magnetic field with the horizontal at a place is called as magnetic inclination or angle of dip. See this. This is the magnetic needle. This is the horizontal component of earth magnetic field. Okay. This is the total earth magnetic field. Therefore, the angle between the horizontal component of earth magnetic field and total earth magnetic field is called as a angle of dip. It is denoted by letter phi. Earth magnetic field means here we consider the total earth magnetic field. It is denoted by letter B. In this diagram, there are the two components of earth magnetic field. One of its BH, horizontal component of earth magnetic field, and vertical component of earth magnetic field. And this is the total earth magnetic field denoted by letter B vector. Okay, then the angle between BH and B is called as a phi. Magnetic force experienced per unit pole strain is magnetic field B vector at that place. It can be resolved in component along the horizontal BH and vertical BV. The vertical component can be conveniently determined. The two components can be related with the angle of dip phi as BH is equal to the B cos phi. Use the trigonometry and obtain the equation for BH. BH is equal to the B cos phi. Okay, from this geometry of figure, BV is equal to the B sin phi. Therefore, take the ratio of these two quantity. BV upon BH is equal to the tan phi. Okay, and B square is equal to the, use Pythagoras theorem, and B square is equal to the BV square plus BH square. Okay, therefore B is equal to the under root of BV square plus BH square. There are some special cases which are important. First one is, at the magnetic north pole, B vector is equal to the BV directed upward, BH vector is equal to 0 and phi is equal to the 90 degree at the magnetic north pole. Second, at the magnetic south pole, B vector is equal to the BV vector directed downward, BH vector is equal to 0 and phi is equal to the 270 degree. Third, anywhere on the magnetic great circle, that is magnetic equator, great circle is called as a magnetic equator, you know this very well. Therefore, B is equal to BH along south to north, BV is equal to 0 and phi is equal to 0. These three cases are important related to the earth magnetic field. Next point is magnetic maps of the earth. Magnetic maps of the earth is defined as, you know that magnetic elements of the earth, that is BH, alpha and phi, vary from place to place and also with time. The maps providing these values at different location are called magnetic maps. These maps are useful for navigation. This is the application for magnetic maps. Magnetic maps drawn by joining places with same value of a particular element are called isomagnetic chart. Lines joining the places of equal horizontal component BH are known as isodynamic lines. Second, lines joining the places of equal declination are called isogonic lines. Third, lines joining the places of equal inclination or angle of dip phi are called aclinic lines. This is the last point of the chapter, magnetism. Let us stop.